Calmly, as quietly as possible, go!
The students are really good. It usually takes about 30 to 35 seconds to set it up. We have a little competition in the year group and in the school where we try to see who can set it up the quickest. We are one of the quickest in the year, if not the quickest.
I feel like circle time is for to share our ideas.
It gives us time to reflect on what's happening in the world and understand how other people may be feeling.
You talk about like who do we want to be and like and why.
How are you going to make today a good day? What are you going to do today to make it a particularly good day today?
Be nice with my teachers.
Well, my name's Mr. Fox. I'm an RE teacher here at St. Francis of Assisi. We've just completed a circle time with a year 8 class. Usually takes the format of debating the topic. Today we just done a check-in and a check-out.
My name's Emma Boylan and I'm subject leader for science. We do circle time every week on a Friday. I think it's really accessible. I think for me personally, I started with very simple questions like, what are you doing this weekend? Or what's your favourite hobby? And then it's progressed into more debate and conversations where the students all feel like they can get involved.
When we first did it, it was like kind of awkward because we didn't really know each other that well as we do now. So we didn't really say what we wanted to say because we didn't know how people would react.
You felt nervous because if you'd expressed your feelings, you might like think that someone's going to laugh at you, so you just kept quiet.
But then, whatever, like you said, inside of the circle, it stays inside the circle, so like you didn't need to worry about what other people might think about you because it's inside the form and it doesn't get spread.
Some students engage with it quite a lot, some are a little bit quieter. But the quiet students we tend to go back to and ask for follow-up questions. But most students tend to engage and really enjoy it.
We've got lots of students here that are quite shy or timid and normally wouldn't have their voice heard, so I think that's really important. And it also gives me as a form tutor the opportunity to learn a little bit more about the students outside of the classroom.
It makes you feel that you can confide in your form and they wouldn't tell anyone what you say.
Like, we're comfortable around, like, the people around us because, like, we've had, like, a year with them now, so, like, we've got to know them better. So.
I've spoken to a group in a circle and they've said, I can go a whole week. One of them said to me, I can go a whole week without answering a question in school because they're used to just withdrawing and they're pushing themselves and challenging themselves. So it's given a voice to all students, especially the ones who would be less confident and less vocal in a classroom situation.
But sometimes out of something really bad can come something a lot better. This is what we've learnt in school through doing restorative practices, isn't it? That, you know, it's okay, yeah, we might well say if somebody hits you, hit them back, but does that resolve anything?
No. Because, like, they're not just making people hate them, they're making people hate the whole religion and making people discriminate against that religion when the other people haven't done nothing.
Good things about circle time is like where say like you've got like the confident people and like the shy people in the form, like, but in circle time like everyone's just confident because you just know that no one's gonna laugh at us, so I just think that's good.
It makes you think like if I can talk in front of like a group of people then I can talk to like anyone. And if I can share my emotions, then I can share with other people because in a way it like makes you feel better and it like brings like a weight off your shoulders.
It might help some people because like some people mightn't have anyone to speak to at home, so like circle time might be the only opportunity to speak about the feelings.
As soon as my students come in on a Friday morning, they just know straight away, they get their chairs and they get in a circle. So it's building that up and it does take a little bit of time and it does take practice with the students.
We've talked about bad situations in the world and how they could be prevented.
We've talked about racism.
We asked how we feel.
You do a check-in and check-out to see what people do to improve their day.
Okay, everyone, so that was a really good check-out. Okay, a lot of you had some really nice ideas there and some that I particularly liked, such as Talani's holding her nerve. That was a really nice one.
Our checkout is, what superpower would you have if you could have anyone? So I would be able to do anything.
Mine would be to time travel, because if something bad happens, then you can just go back in time and resolve it.
Mine's just psychokinetic powers, because then I can mind meld people's minds.
So I'll try to like